But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring you to the end of all the misery that you have in your life when you are drifting away from the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So seeking forgiveness is something that as Muslims we should do and we do. But we should do this in ways that would bring it truly into our hearts. Sometimes we say Astaghfirullah al-Azim, but had we reflected upon what we are saying? Did we know whom we are talking to? Did we bring in our hearts the might, the generosity, and the goodness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? We say this usually, habitually, with our lips, but we need to do it with our hearts and to reflect that we are petitioning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness. And Allah the Mighty, who has given us all the bounties that we have, we are asking Him for additional bounty to forgive us, to forgive our sins, and He is able and He is forgiving as we are told in the Quran. So saying this with our tongues is one way. Another way to attain the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is to be forgiving in nature. If you look at the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his nature was very forgiving. Many people attacked him when he was weak. Many people denied him as a prophet and called him many names, but he forgave them. And if you look at the story of Yusuf alayhi salam, which we covered in a previous khutbah, let's reflect upon Yusuf alayhi salam and all the trouble that he went through because his brothers plotted against him and wanted to see him disappear from the face of the earth. When he brought his brothers and his parents into him, يَغْفِرُ اللَّهُ لِي وَلَكُمْ لَا تَثْرِيبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الْيَوْمِ I'm not going to go back and hold you accountable. I have forgiven you, and I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive you. Not only that, he asked Allah to forgive him himself. يَغْفِرُ اللَّهُ لِي وَلَكُمْ May Allah give me forgiveness for myself and for you. And this is in the Quran. If you forgive others, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reciprocate by forgiving you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in the Quran, فَعَفُوا وَصْفَحُوا Forgive and do not hold grudge against people. أَلَا تُحِبُّونَ أَن يَغْفِرَ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ Don't you like that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive you? If you want Him to forgive you, then be forgiving. Do not always have a long account of the mistakes of the others, of the problems of the others, because then you will live indeed a very miserable life. If you look at the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and how forgiving he was, even to the people who killed his uncle, for example, the man who ambushed his uncle, and he became a believer in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When he came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he forgave him. Many instances, people think or thought that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is not going to let things go. He will not be forgiving, but he would surprise his enemies more than his friends by his nature that he was always willing to forgive for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not only that, when he felt that he did something wrong to a human being, he would ask that human being to forgive him. In the battle of Badr, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was positioning his army, he was lining the army at the front line, and he wanted them to be in a straight line. And with a small stick in his hand, he pushed it in the belly of one of his companions to make him straight. And that man said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as if he felt pain, and the Prophet felt that he has done something wrong to this man. The leader of the army was basically positioning his troops, and he felt that he did something wrong to one of his troops. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam showed him his stomach and said to him, push me as I did. And that man went and kissed the belly of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. This is how the Prophet was seeking the forgiveness of those around him. And he told his companions always to be forgiving. And he was following the example set by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran. If you want the forgiveness of Allah, then forgive others around you. And this will result not only in the forgiveness of Allah, but it will result in people loving you, in people admiring you, and in people saying how high you are in your esteem to yourself, that you do not care about the harm and the damage, because you seek the recompensation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not from the servants of Allah. And Allah will give you much more than you can expect from any other people, any people that can give you around you. Another way to seek the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is by doing good deeds. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us in the Quran that you can cover a bad deed with a good deed. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us that if you have been clouded, if your vision has been clouded by the shaitan, then you should seek forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the cloud will go away, the vision will come back to you. And always doing a good deed will result in the maghfirah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this dunya and in the hereafter. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam told us that if you give for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for example, whether you give your time or your wealth, what would be the result? The result will be that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you back what you have given. So forgiveness could be sought by